Alright, so before we go on to the digital marathons, I'm here in this world. This is the world where you will do the digital marathon, and this is the world simulated from forecasted data, right? So let's take you through the world and also present the first keynote speech, which is on what is exponential exactly. Alright, so well, everybody speaks about exponential, but what truly is this term exponential? So here's the deal. If you take 30 steps linear forward, then you go 30 steps forward. But if you take 30 steps exponential forward, then you go 26, you take 26 trips around the world. That is now an analogy of what exponential looks like. So here's why the term exponential is a big deal. Technology is moving exponentially. If you see, it took thousands of years to go from agricultural revolution to the industrial revolution, just 120 to go from industrial revolution to the light bulb, and just 90 years to go from light bulb to moon landing, and just 22 years to go from moon landing to the world wide web, and just 9 years to go from the world wide web to human genome sequencing. But now we have these kind of milestone technological events happening on a daily basis. That's a pattern, you can see that, right? There is this exponential growth happening in computing power, right? So basically we are soon reaching a time when the power of one computer will be more greater than the brains of all human beings on the planet put together. This is the singularity moment. It's slated to happen in 2045, but it can be easily understood that by 2030, which is just 7.5 years away, even if we have 1/10 that power, then we can look at one computer being as powerful as the brains of a billion people put together, right? So what would the world look like in a scenario like that? Did you know that Apollo 11 was landed on the moon using a computer that had 1,300 times less processing power than the iPhone 5? Can you imagine that? A computer that put a man on the moon was still 1,300 times less powerful than the phone in your hand. This is how fast computation power is moving. We know that technology is now more integrated into human lives than ever. So now the same technology that we live with and do things with on a daily basis, on a minute-by-minute basis, is changing and growing at exponential speeds. The same exponential concept that was explained to you earlier. And hence we have a problem. And this is the problem. If you check this chart out, you can see that the human mind is wired to think linear, but technology is growing exponentially. So linear here can be represented by the sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and so on. But exponential means 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512, 1024, 2048, and so on. So now this chart explains the scenario even more clearly, right? So you can pause the scene and check out the chart in detail if you like. There's a pause button. So now the issue here is that if we keep thinking linear, then we end up in the same scenario as the person in 2030 shown in the chart. So you can see that he's in a lot of issues, unprepared for sci-fi worlds in the era of industries 4.0 and 5.0. Closing that gap that we spoke about in the previous chart is actually a survival requirement for all human beings and businesses. But yet there is a challenge here. Challenge is that we need to reinvent ourselves every year if we are to keep the gap closed. Professor here, Yanis C. Yotsos, head of University Viterbi School of Engineering, Southern California, has to say this. There are no longer steady states or even steady states in growth. Changes will be exponential. We need to reinvent ourselves every year. So now here are some others who agree with the presence of this problem. This is Mr. Richard Riley, former Secretary of Education, United States, and he says, we are currently preparing students for jobs that don't yet exist using technologies that haven't been invented in order to solve problems we don't even know our problems yet. And here is Mr. Kevin Frey, Global Chief Executive of UNICEF Generation Unlimited, and he has said this. There is an urgent need to prepare young people for futuristic jobs. There is an urgent need to prepare our young people to be responsible adults by preparing them for types of jobs that are yet to be created, for technologies not yet invented, to solve problems not yet anticipated. Here's what Mr. Ray Kurzweil has to say about this. Ray Kurzweil is a very, very popular futurist who now works with Google in a very senior position, and he has a track record of 86% accuracy when it comes to predicting emerging technologies and emerging worlds. And this is what he says: our intuition about the future is linear, but the reality of information technology is exponential, and that makes a profound difference. If I take 30 steps linearly, I get to 30. If I take 30 steps exponentially, I get to a billion. This is something else that he has to say about the scenario. By 2029, computers will have emotional intelligence and will be as convincing as people. As Albert Allen Baffert famously put it, the greatest shortcoming of the human race is our inability to understand the exponential function. Progress is exponential, not linear. Bill Gates. We'll experience more technological progress in the coming decade than we did in the preceding 100 years put together, says McKinsey. So if we ignore this gap and go linearly with the fixed mindset approach, where do we end up? Answer is nowhere. We end up in scenarios where humans find themselves more or more obsolete for any kind of work. Here are some stats to prove this. A majority of executives around the world say that 1 in 5 current jobs will be replaced by artificial intelligence and automation. 42% of core skills required to perform existing jobs will change in the next 2 years. 73% of executives predict significant industry disruption in the next 3 years, which was in 2018. The links to all of this is in the Links channel. By 2030, in the US alone, there will be 8.1 million fewer jobs in the office support segment, 5.4 million fewer jobs in the food service segment, 4.8 million fewer jobs in the production work department, 4.4 million fewer jobs in customer service and sales, 2.2 million fewer jobs in the area of builders in the construction industry. And if machines and clouds take up jobs, then we end up with large cities left with no source of financial sustenance. We end up with abandoned and desolate cities. We end up with massive levels of unemployment. We find scenarios like food crisis and poverty increasing. So we need to close this gap. So how do we do this? We need to do this by developing the right and future-ready mindset through mass digital transformation. We've noticed that there are five different kinds of mindset when it comes to digital transformation. First mindset we'd like to call the 80s, 90s mindset. They think that 2030 is going to look like the 80s or the 90s, but that's not true. Then we find another group of folks who call themselves the Nowaholics. They have taken the art of being in the now to unhealthy extremes. They think 2030 will look like today, but that's not true. Then we have another group of people we call the today-space folks. They know that there will be technological advancements in 2030, but they think that the speed of change will remain constant. That's not true either. As a matter of fact, the speed of change, if you look at history, was always increasing. Then we have the folks who are more realistic, and we call them the futuristic folks. And many of the digital transformation work happening around the planet falls into this category. We call them the fast-paced folks. Now, they know that there will be radical changes in technology and that the speed of change will increase at a fast pace. And hence, 2030 will look radically different than the worlds of 2022. But I'm sorry to say that even they got this wrong. So now let's come to the fifth group of people who gets it right. They know that the speed of technological growth is not just increasing at a fast pace, but at an exponential pace. And at that pace, the only way to visualize 2030, which is just 7 years away, would be sci-fi and nothing less. So if 7 years down the line is sci-fi, then we know that we need to have the mindsets of students, workers, and business owners aligned with the exponential mindset. They need to understand the right unlearn and relearn strategies that aligns with this exponential mindset. Therefore, we need to close this gap between the required exponential mindset and the current fixed mindset. So how do we close this gap? Sci-fi classrooms and the session that you're attending closes the gap as shown in the diagram. So then, let's dive into Emerging World, which is a data city simulation created based on techniques mentioned, and start our first activity-based learning module called the Digital Marathons. Please view the Discord server channel named Digital Marathons to know rules and participate.